The Dino Crisis 2 Classic Rebirth mod has finally been released. I have been anticipating this one a lot since Dino Crisis 2 is one of my favorite games ever, and the installation is very straightforward. This mod brings features to the game such as making it compatible with modern GPUs, support for PlayStation and Xbox controller, and a new option to remap the controls in-game, restores missing sound effects and music loops, and fixes the broken graphical effects. There's also a couple of extra mods to enhance the FMV cutscene's quality and the sound effects. This is the best way right now to experience Dino Crisis 2. So, let's get started. This mod was designed to work around the Source Next re-release of Dino Crisis 2 for PC, that is the Japanese version of the game. But any Japanese version will work as long as you have this executable right here on the game folder. And I can't show you here on the video where to go or even mention where you can get it, because this is against YouTube's policy. And when you install it, it's important that you keep on the default location that the installer tells you. That is the program files 86. It's going to create a Capcom folder and inside a Dino 2 folder, which is this one right here. Now, assuming that you have the game with you, we're gonna head over to the Classic Rebirth page right here. I'll put the link of this one down below somewhere. And right here on the main page, you're gonna see the download and links section right here. And we're gonna get the mod itself, this DLL file here, and also the high quality videos and sound effects. There is also a mod in development to enhance the soundtrack of the game, but it's not available yet. So if you're interested in that, keep coming back to this page right here to see if this one was already released. So now the first step is to download each of these files right here. And it's a straightforward process here. Just open the page and then click on the download button of each one of them. And you can leave it on the folder of your preference on your PC. I went ahead and created a folder called DC2 mods just to keep everything organized, but I already have all three files right here. These two you have to extract it before moving. You can use either WinRAR or 7-zip, that's up to you. And the process is very simple. I have the game folder here open. I'm gonna start with the Classic Rebirth file right here. You just gotta press and hold with the left button on your mouse. Bring it over here and then let go. Click on continue, move this. Now I have to extract these two files. Both of them inside, you're gonna have this CR folder on it. So I'm gonna start with the high quality cutscenes. Move it over here, click on continue, let it do its thing, and then do the same thing for the sound effects mod as well, like this. And we're pretty much done here. You can close this folder now. And then just double click on dino2.exe. When you open for the first time, you're likely gonna have an option here saying that it couldn't find the settings.ini, but it will create for you. So you just click on OK, and then the configuration window of the mod will appear. The API and the card option are gonna be gray by default. You're not supposed to change this, but it will work just as fine. You can change the resolution right here. This game works on borderless full screen if you select as such. It can go all the way to 4K if you have a monitor like this. Some extra options here too. This one is gonna be up to you, but I like turning on the texture filtering and the SMAA here, anti-aliasing. You can also disable the motion trail effect that happens especially in the underwater section of the game. It's gonna be up to you. On the sound section, you can increase the music volume all the way right here to the max, but the SFX, I would keep my right here. It was a bit too loud when I tested the game, so you're gonna have to test it for yourself, but you can change this in-game too if you feel like it. Some gameplay options here too if you wanna enable sidestepping. This is to enable the door animation sequence whenever you go from one room to another, and also the target lock-on as well. And on the bottom, you can change the input device. If you're playing with an Xbox controller, you're gonna choose X input. If you're using a PlayStation controller, then you select direct input. Or if you're on a keyboard, you just select raw input. And on the bottom, you can change the device if you have multiple, that is. And you can rebind the controls here as well. But you can also do this in game too. Vibration intensity is probably something that's coming in one of the later updates. And also here, if you want to enable the original Japanese text, ignore focus if the game is out of focus on Windows 2. And if you want to disable the cutscenes whenever they play, this is the option right here. And this one is an option that if you want this screen to show up every time you start the game, this one has to be checked. If you uncheck it, that option, and you want it to come back, first you're gonna right-click on the executable of the game with the right button, and then you're gonna click on Send To, and then select the desktop to create a shortcut of that. Then you're gonna right-click on the shortcut and select Properties, and you're gonna head over here to the Shortcut tab. And here where it says Target, you're gonna go to the end of this string, and you're gonna press space once, and then press line, and then type config, exactly like this. Then click on apply, and then select OK. And with this, we are done here, so go ahead and click here on OK, and just like that, the game will start. I have many videos like this covering how to install and play games on PC, so if you like what you saw, don't forget to check out my other stuff, subscribe to the channel, and also leave a like on this video. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you soon.